So here's an easy family meal that comes together pretty quick, and it's a great way to use greens out of your garden here in the spring. I love me some southern peas. And so I'm going to throw some greens in here with them, and I'm going to make some cornmeal dumplings. So what I had growing in my garden was some spinach, and the leaves were very large, and so I thought this would be a great substitute for something like collards or turnip greens. I'll probably make this again as soon as my turnip greens are ready to harvest, but right now I'm going to use this wonderful spinach. So we had a very cold winter. Oh my goodness, it seemed like it was snowing every couple of weeks. And you know, I don't cover my garden beds. Spinach has overwintered for me several times over the past several years. And I was kind of scared this year that it might not do well for me, but it did. It did just fine. And so I'm also going to use some chives. I'm using garlic chives. You can use common chives, or you know, use scallions. So here are the ingredients. You're welcome to do a screen capture, or they'll also be down below the video where you can print them out. So let's go ahead and get started. I want to just first fry some bacon. This is a nice applewood smoked bacon, has a lot of flavor in it, and so I guess I ended up frying about 8 pieces total, and I divided that. Half will go in the peas and the other half are going into the dumplings. Make sure to reserve your bacon grease. We'll need that for the dumplings. And I ended up with about 3 tablespoons of bacon grease. You don't really need more than that. And then into the Dutch oven, I went ahead and put a sweet onion, one large sweet onion, and that helped lift off all of the bacon goodness at the bottom of the pot. So just cook those on about medium heat and let those onions sweeten up. Meanwhile, I went ahead and prepped my spinach, took out the little vein that goes right up through the center of the spinach. And so now my onions were nice and tender. I went ahead and added some ham stock. You can just use water. There's going to be a lot of flavor in here. I added the bacon, the pepper, and some salt, and then some frozen field peas with snaps. You can use crowder peas too, would be good, I think. So I'm actually cooking 2 bags of frozen peas because this makes a great leftover side dish for the family with something else later in the week. So I just covered them up with water and I brought those to a boil and then reduced them to a simmer, covered for about 20 minutes. Now I can go ahead and prepare the dumplings. And so in a little bowl here, in goes the cornmeal along with the flour. And I'm using self-rising, but I'm also adding a little bit more baking powder just to make sure these stay nice and light, along with some sugar and some black pepper. And we'll go ahead and mix that up real good. Add the rest of the bacon and your chives. Now I'm using 1.5 cups of buttermilk, and to that I added the grease from the bacon. And so we are just going to slowly pour this in here. Don't use your whisk, get you a spatula, because we want to do this slowly and very gently. I don't want to have a big, dense, tough dumpling, okay? You may not need to use 1.5 cups. That's why I say slowly, until it all just seems to come together, and that's when you'll stop adding the buttermilk. Okay, so we are almost there. This is looking pretty good. I stopped adding the buttermilk. Now we just want this to rest for about 10 minutes while those peas continue to cook. And I want to go ahead and tear the spinach just a little bit more here and make sure those leaves are broken down so they will be nice in the peas. So the peas are cooking nice. They are thickening up a little bit. The starch is releasing from those peas and it's turning into almost like a little thin gravy. And so in goes the spinach. I brought up the heat just a little bit to about medium low, and now I can go ahead and add the dumplings. And so I wanted to wet my hands with some water first because this dough is kind of sticky here. So go ahead and just drop those in there after you just shape them very gently. So I think I ended up with about 9 dumplings. So you'll cook these for about 20 minutes until they're done, and then you can spoon just a little bit of that liquid right over the dumplings before you serve them. And I just love them served with a little bit of chow chow on the side, so you get a little bit of that sweet vinegar flavor, and then some hot sauce right there on top. And the cornmeal dumpling is just icing on the cake. It is so nice and light and just full of flavor with those chives in there and the bacon. I hope you can try it soon. It's just wonderful. And if you want some more recipe ideas, feel free to head on over to my channel where I have a playlist section with a lot of other recipes. And don't forget to click that little bell off to the right of the subscribed button, and you'll receive all notifications for my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and y'all have a beautiful day.